Welcome to MarcusG.TV. I am Chef Marcus Giuliano, and I'm a chef on a mission.
Today's mission is truth in menu, also known as menu labeling.
One of my true passions.
Marcus, I wanted to ask you about the top items that have been found to be mislabeled in restaurants. We just read a really great article, and it talks about the examples of things that are mislabeled in restaurants, or the highest, you know,
This is the latest news, this article. It's from the LA Times, I believe. And this is a brand new article, a day old. Read some of the statistics in there of how much is mislabeled in the samples they did, because this is a serious problem.
So the Department of Public Health Seafood Task Force found that they went to 103 retail food facilities, and they inspected, including 66 restaurants, 37 food markets, and 74% of the facilities investigated had labeling misbranding or false advertising on menus, and over 180 violations.
This is a serious problem, folks. It's happening every day, every time you go out. Things are mislabeled on menus.
Mislabeled, and also things are substituted for other things. So in this article, it talks about things that are substituted. Crawfish for lobster. Let's see, farm-raised salmon for wild salmon, which you're a huge advocate of.
Yes.
Fluke for halibut. Pollock and tilapia are substituted for snapper. Fluke is substituted for halibut. An imitation crab, an octopus, an imitation crab abalone and octopus sold as a real product.
Real product, right. So you can have imitation crab, imitation octopus, imitation abalone. Abalone sold as a real
abalone.
Deal. Yep.
So I wanted to ask you, what is the most common items, you know, that you have found on menus that are mislabeled?
Let's start with first, whose fault is it? So it can be the chef's fault trying to make a profit, or the retail store trying to substitute things in and making a profit because they're buying cheaper products and selling them for more money. It could be the processor's fault, the person who's packing the fish. And when you skin a fish, put it into a box and you just have the fillets and freeze it, you can really sell it as anything. Once it's in its fillet form and it's sitting there as a white fillet, it can be sold as really anything, like the article says. And how things are substituted. Salmon, if you clean a salmon, you look at two salmon fillets side by side, it's hard for the average person to tell the difference between wild salmon versus farm salmon. So it can be anybody's fault along the way. And it's usually sparred through greed because they know they can make extra money. That's usually the motive behind it. So your question was, what are the most common items? So of course, the common items that I see are salmon. Salmon is a huge, huge one because I can pinpoint that. It's harder for me to pinpoint, you know, fluke for halibut, let's say. You know, the fish are totally different and they're totally different sizes. But you don't see it as much. I think you see the salmon far, far more, where people are just throwing the term wild salmon out there and they're just getting farm salmon. And a lot of times it's a combination of because they want to make more money and they're buying a product that's half the price, or that they believe that, as I spoke to one restaurateur, that it's from the ocean, so it has to be wild, even though it's in pens and cages. So salmon is one that's a really, really a large problem.
What are some of the other terms that could be a problem?
Because it might not just be the actual fish being a problem. It could be terms like organic. Organic is a word that is abused a lot. People just throw the word organic on things because they think that it, you know, it was grown on a farm because it came out of the dirt, because it's local.
Well, it also is a key word that kind of catches people's attention.
It's a key word that catches people's attention. There's a local restaurant here that serves Murray's Chickens right up the road from us that advertises Murray's Chickens as organic. Murray's Chickens are not organic. They're advertised as natural, free-roaming, pesticide-free food, and you know, they give a little checklist, Murray's, of what an organic chicken would be and what their chicken would be with all the checks on it. So it's easy maybe for a restaurant to confuse that, but the restaurant is flat out saying it's organic. And a friend of mine pointed it out to the restaurant, and they said, no, it's organic, it's organic. It's not organic. So organic is one that's really, really abused.
So what about the word natural? That's another one.
That's another word that has no definition. See, organic has a definition. USDA laws have defined definitions of organic. So natural has no bearing when you say the word natural. It's just, you can say anything's natural. You can say things aren't processed, you know, so they're natural. And they could be genetically modified. They could be high, you know, they could have pesticides on them. They could be anything. But, you know, basically, if the carrot looks like the carrot, no matter what it took to grow the carrot, they can say it's natural. Now, going back to the word organic for a second, organic, I did say it has definitions except for like an aquaculture. Aquaculture, there are no definitions for organic. So it's self-regulated by this, by the fish industry and the farm to what they deem as organic. It's very misleading. Other than that, organic has strict definitions for food. Cosmetics, it has no definition as well. It's self-regulated. So natural, you know, it's don't even, when you see the word natural, you
definitely need to read further into what that product is meaning by natural.
Right, which usually means nothing. It's usually a useless word, waste of space, and they're charging more for something that really, there's no justification for it. So, you know, other things that are marked natural can be beef, chicken, things like that you see naturally processed when we know that they're not natural. I had a great conversation with somebody who owns a slaughterhouse in Colorado, and I asked him, I said, is your meat natural, organic? I know I was asking these questions, this was years ago, and he goes, Marcus, there's nothing natural about trucking a cow into a slaughterhouse and us putting this animal down. That's not natural to begin with. So we've already, you know, his feeling was very strict on this. He's like, it's not natural to do this to cattle, to put them into a processing plant and slaughter them like this. That's not natural. So, you know, he was taking it to the extreme, but he's just saying that was his definition. So chicken, beef is all kinds of things labeled natural. You know, other things that are
labeled.
What
about, I was just gonna say, what about some other things that are labeled and I think sometimes misconstrued by the labeling process? Could you tell us a little bit about trans fats, GMO products,
sure,
and also MSG?
And chemicals and stuff like that. So you'll see natural on things like Mother's cereal, or other things. You know, when they say natural, and they're using genetically modified foods in these. Well, there's, to us who know about genetically modified foods are far from natural. They're made in a laboratory. They're made by scientists. They're made with deception of Mother Nature. But because they look the same sometimes and they act the same sometimes, companies get away with calling this corn natural, genetically modified corn natural, genetically modified wheat natural, genetically modified alfalfa as natural when it's not natural, because Mother Nature could never produce those. And other things like trans fats, you see the label natural on this, natural on that, and there's trans fats in it, there's MSG in it, there's things in it that just aren't that natural. And you're just like, you have to read the back side of the box. You can't read what they're advertising on the front of the package or the box. That's their billboard. That's how they're going to catch your attention. That's where they know to use those key words. But even restaurants that use the term natural and stuff like that, there's nothing natural about frying a French fry in hydrogenated oil. There's nothing natural about that. And they claim that these things are natural, and they're not. You know, so natural is, again, just a definition that you just want to totally look at and say, I don't think this holds any weight to really what it is. Natural is you growing something organically in your backyard. That's natural, okay?
Marcus, what is greenwashing?
Greenwashing is another term that is applied to people that misrepresent the true facts. A lot of restaurants like to say they do green practices and say, oh, we're green and we do this green, we do that green, when in fact, they're doing it self-regulated. See, there are agencies out there like the Green Restaurant Association and other agencies that will come in and certify you and go through your invoices and audit you and make sure you're doing what you say you're doing. Greenwashing is basically saying, oh, we're green and we're doing it on our own, and making your own claims when they're not really true, or they could be fabricated, or you're really playing that word green more than, you're upplaying it more than you're actually doing. A lot of places do that, and their definition of green sometimes is maybe buying recyclable to-go containers, biodegradable to-go containers, but not do any of the other 30, 40 steps that they should be doing, like water implementation, LED light bulbs, composting, recycling, you know, they're not doing the other things. They're just doing one or two things and saying, oh, we're green, and putting this on their website and on their to-go menus and thing, or in their restaurant. And it's a scam. You have to ask, who are you certified by? What regulatory agency oversees? Who's your certification from? And what exact steps are you doing? How many steps are you doing? 5 steps, 15 steps, 30 steps, 40 steps? What are you doing exactly? Is there a list of what I can see what you're doing exactly?
So what should consumers do to make sure that they're getting the right labeled foods?
You know, you have to build relationships. You have to trust who you're buying from. You know, even when you trust sometimes who you're buying from, like we were told one night that at a restaurant that a friend of mine goes to all the time in Jersey, that the cookies were vegan. And I'm looking at him, I'm like, he's been telling you this for how long? Those cookies are not vegan. Those cookies are made with eggs.
And butter.
There's animal products in here. They're just saying vegan just because you're asking if the cookies are vegan. They're just telling you what you want to hear. And it's really, really wrong. The cookies might be good, but they're not vegan. Another thing, you know, on the natural side is, you know, the hormone-free, antibiotic-free, grass-fed versus grain-fed beef and the whole local thing. Those are all misconstrued. Now, here's my problem with things when farms say or restaurants say, well, this beef is antibiotic-free. Was the animal raised antibiotic-free, or was it weaned off of antibiotics? And was every animal tested for antibiotics? Because a lot of times, beef doesn't come from...
So really what you want to look for is a never, ever... Rather than...
Never, ever administered hormones. Never, ever administered antibiotics. That's what you want to look for. But here's the problem. And these co-ops, which most beef comes from a co-op where they trade hands several times, or a group of 100 or 800 or 2,000 farmers get together and say, we want to market a brand, so let's put our beef into this branded co-op. You know, I learned a long time ago from one of these so-called branded co-ops in Colorado. This was explained to me how their antibiotic free was. Well, we wean them off for 30 to 60 days of antibiotics. Then we take one animal out of 100 and send it to Colorado State University and test it for any antibiotic residues. And then we label the whole batch as antibiotic free. And I looked at them and said, that's a scam. It's a downright scam. You're touting something's antibiotic free, but it was given antibiotics, and you're not testing every animal. You don't know where every animal's coming from because it's coming from a co-op. Who knows what these farmers are doing? And when it's about the money, because antibiotics make animals grow bigger and fatter and quicker, when it's about the money, people do very deceitful things. The way to really trust something is by knowing your local beef supplier from a farmer's market where you can actually go visit what he's doing and say, these are my 40 animals, 50 animals out on the grass. This is what I'm going to plan on processing this year, and this is what I'm selling. Would you like some of my beef from right there? That's a much more guaranteed way of buying a pure product than going and buying a branded co-op or a brand or anything else from a grocery store.
So truthfully, you want people that you can trust. And I think that the consumer needs to go out there and find people and restaurants and farmers markets and farmers and all of that type of stuff so that they can find someone that
they can trust.
And truthfully, are the grocery stores or...
They don't work relationships like that. Some grocery stores, Whole Foods has done certain things. So I know, you know, they'll take a local animal from a local farmer like once a week, and you know, but who knows really what's happening in between? Are they grinding it? Are they grinding with other things? I mean, not to say anybody's to pointing fingers at anybody, but as good as a lot of them do, they do good and they try to do things, but there is just a gap in buying it from a grocery store than walking to the farm stand and getting it from the farmer directly. So you have to find somebody who really, Jamie, the point of this is you have to find places that can teach you. When you walk into a restaurant, you want an education on your food and where it's from and how it's produced and the season of when it's in and things like that. I mean, you want a restaurant to be 100% honest and say, you know what, we have wild salmon, but it's not in season right now, so we buy a line-caught salmon that's frozen at sea, high-quality product, and, you know, give you the brand, like, you know, Alaska Gold or whoever it comes from, and that's what we serve in the off-season when the wild salmon in Alaska is not in season. And if they tell you that, you know that they're being honest, because they're doing transparency. They're telling you about. You go on their website and you go see what's going on with their food and see their farms. And, you know, it's not good enough sometimes just to look at a menu and say, oh, we support this farm, and that farm. No, I want to know more information. You know, I want the service staff, the servers, the associates to be really knowledgeable. I want the chef to be very knowledgeable. I want them to really explain that on the menu, on their website, on blogs, you know, a lot like we do. You want to go to a farmer's market where you can meet the farmer and have dialogue with the farmer and know all about what's going on and have somebody say, it's an open door policy. We'll open our doors and we'll show you. The last time we went to a processing plant, Jamie, in Colorado 2 years ago, the owner welcomed us into the processing plant, right? And we had our cameras and he allowed us to take pictures.
Yes.
He has nothing to hide in that slaughterhouse, in that processing plant. Nothing to hide. They're doing things right. Most processing plants would not allow you in. They'd not allow you on the kill floor, and they definitely wouldn't allow you to have a camera on you at all.
Absolutely.
So those are the kind of people that I want to buy from. Those are the kind of people that I do buy from. Those are the kind of people that you want to buy from, where there's pure transparency in what's going on, and you build that, and you trust. And when you find a restaurant, a farm, a farmer's market, a smaller store, whatever, that has that, you support them. You support them, and you pass it along. Now, if you want to go to a restaurant, if you find a great farm and you love their products, you can say, hey, Farmer Joe, where do you sell, what restaurants buy your products? And then he'll tell you his opinion on what restaurants are doing the best job and by sourcing local and how much, you know, he might say, oh, they just buy once or twice a year from me, or they actually buy every week from me. And the chef there is so intense and anal about all the products he brings in. That's where I would personally ask the farmer where he would personally eat. And that goes a long way. So menu labeling, truth in menu, develop a relationship, build trust, and support them. I'm Chef Marcus Giuliano. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please hit like, subscribe, pass it on, share it, tweet it. Thank you very much.